We chose AWS due to their top tier support, their scalability, and our engineers' familiarity with the product. We also really respect the API first approach, which means that we can integrate it with our internal tooling as well.
Leonardo.Ai is a generative AI platform. We're focused on content creation, and really I think what we're trying to solve is reducing the friction between ideation and creation and bringing what is really quite a revolutionary, I guess, shift in terms of what's possible today to everyone, and that includes both consumers and B2B enterprise use cases as well. Where we are right now, we're really focused on 2D image creation. That's sort of at the core of our offering at the moment.
Leonardo.Ai is an amazing story about a company who's been able to innovate and get to market super quickly. This company is less than 12 months old and they've built a phenomenal product which has had a global reach. We're very proud to be working with Leonardo.Ai in deploying their model globally through thousands of users here in Australia, but also in North America and Europe, in Japan, in India, across the whole world, providing global scale, reach, whilst keeping it secure and reliable to run.
AWS have provided us with so many opportunities. They've connected us with so many key partners, and they've also organized many consulting sessions to really level up our engineers. I mean, we work with generative AI, which is relatively new to the space, and working with GPU workloads, which are so much different from working with traditional CPU workloads. So AWS's guidance has really helped us achieve our goals in a really short amount of time.
We sort of started from the gaming space. Obviously, we see huge application across gaming, people using it in pre-production as well as post-production creation, as well as texture creation for 3D assets, film, TV, concepting, storyboarding, advertising and marketing. Obviously, loads of different ways that you can create really exciting, engaging visual content with the platform. Architecture as well, interior design, ways of visualizing rough concept sketches and turn them into polished, finished works that can be used for presenting to clients and so on. So there's a really, really broad range of use cases and beyond that.
With AWS, customers get to choose how they want to use generative AI within their business. You can use generative AI applications from AWS to build your own models. You can use pre-trained models and build your applications on top of those pre-trained models. Or you can use AWS services that have generative AI capability built into them and not having the need to worry about training and deploying models. All of this is managed in a very secure and reliable infrastructure.
Hosting in the cloud is the only option we have because at the scale of the amount of users that we need and the GPUs that we need to power that, and the ability to move to the next generation of GPUs is something that's only easily done through cloud services like AWS. Through the AWS Generative AI Accelerator event, we were introduced to so many industry leaders who are all working on so many exciting products, and we still use some of them to this day to help grow ours.
Hundreds of thousands of startups across the world have benefited from AWS Activate. The program itself is built to provide support to startups in the time that they need early stage support. So we provide expertise around how to scale your business, grow your business, build world-class architecture, both within AWS skills, but also through the ecosystem. In fact, every 10 minutes, a startup signs onto AWS Activate globally.
AWS have easily enabled us to scale outside of Australia, bringing our content closer to customers in the US, Asia, and Europe.
We have a more expansive view about where things can go, and we really see image generation as sort of the seed of something much bigger in terms of content creation. And we're really interested both from a consumer and B2B enterprise perspective of where we can take things.